Well, hopefully that can be sorted out as quickly as possible. We now move over to Ntoroko District, where Prime Minister Robina Nabanja has visited the flood-affected victims of Kanara Sub-County. The Prime Minister and her team spent about 3 hours travelling on top of the rising water levels of Lake Albert as they assessed the dire situation there. We have this report. Prime Minister Robina Nabanja was in company of 5 other ministers, including Esther Anyakun from the Ministry of Disaster Preparedness, Mary Grace Mugasa from Public Service, Judith Nabakova from Lands, Helen Adoa from Fisheries, Fred Biamukama from Works and Transport, and other government officials. They boarded engine boats at Kanara Town Council landing site. Nabanja visited the parishes of Katanga, Kamuga, Ruangara and Kimara, all of which were completely submerged by the rising waters of Lake Albert. The Prime Minister was shocked to learn that over 150 families whose land was submerged were living and surviving on top of water. Banja stated that the Ntoroko flood victims were the most needy community she has ever seen in Uganda.
I want to implore Ugandans and my fellow leaders, whenever they hear that there is a problem, to come and see. You can imagine raising a child like this. The type of Ugandan you can raise. And therefore, I want to inform my fellow colleagues in cabinet and my fellow colleagues in parliament that these people, they are Ugandans and they must raise children. And that's why I wanted to use, or I will use the 5 billion that I got from the food relief to see people like this situation.
The rising Lake Albert water that hit the district started in September 2019. Until now, the water levels have not reduced, whereas close to 3,000 of the affected households were relocated to internally displaced persons' camps, more than 150 households remain trapped in the middle of the lake. These live in makeshift temporary houses made out of wood and iron sheets that have been mounted on top of the submerged houses. Williams Kasoro, the Ntoroko District Chairperson, says 95% of the Kanara Sub-County surface land has all been submerged.
People who are living on the landing sites that were completely submerged, Kamuga, Katanga, Ruangara, others are in Mulango, near the border with DRC, inside the lake. And when their houses got completely submerged, people bought timber and raised storied structures. We call them skyscrapers here in Ntoroko. So you find mothers, young children, hanging in those wooden structures inside the lake, because it is now a lake.
Friday Mugisa, the Kanara Sub-County Chairperson, says this has affected the delivery of social services in the area.
The revenue has reduced because we are collecting to a tune of 30 million. But as I speak right now, we are collecting like 2 million in a quarter, and which 2 million can't sustain the sub-county.
The district also proposed to the government to degazate part of the Toro Semiliki Wildlife Reserve for human settlement.
Katunguru and Kazigiso in Masaka Parish, Tungama sub-county, were completely submerged, and the lake has become a permanent feature there. And these people's livestock is now encroaching on the wildlife reserve, Semiliki Wildlife Reserve, and they are being harassed seriously by UWA officials. They impound their animals, make them pay hefty fines, sometimes imprison them. Their life is not good. Yet these are people who are victims of a situation.
Report by Roger Sunday for the news in Ntoroko District.